Welcome to Bio-Rad's Blackboard Training. This is a series of short, informal tutorials brought to you by industry experts. Today, we'll cover Pearson's correlation coefficient. The Pearson's correlation coefficient is an equation that represents the strength and direction of the relationship between two sets of data. The coefficient is often represented with an R. You can determine the correlation in two ways. Visually, which is what we covered in a previous video on scatter plots, or mathematically. This video will focus on how to determine the correlation mathematically. Let's assume we've plotted x and y data on a graph. In this example, note that the line goes through every data point, creating a perfect line. Also notice that the slope is negative. When both of these occur, we have a perfect negative linear correlation. Data that has a perfect negative linear correlation has a R value of -1. Here's a different example. Notice that the line goes through every data point, also creating a perfect line. But here, the slope is positive. When both of these occur, we have a perfect positive linear correlation. Data that has a perfect positive linear correlation has an R value of 1. In this example, we see data scattered all around the graph. This is said to have no correlation. Data that doesn't seem to be related in any way has an R value of 0. What happens when the data appears to have a linear relationship, but is not perfectly linear? We would get a graph that looks something like this. You can visually see that the data has some correlation and that it's negative. The R value for the relationship between this set of data would be between -1 and 0. In this case, the data in this chart also appears to have some correlation and is positive. The value for the relationship between this set of data would be between 0 and +1. Now let's take another look at the formula to calculate the actual R value of the set of data. There are a few different versions of the formula, but we'll use this one. Before we can solve the equation, let's determine where the values come from. This data could represent many things. In this case, let's say that we are testing a new control material. We want to compare the old lot's values with the new lot. X represents the values for the old lot, and Y represents the new lot. Note that we have 5 sets of X and Y data points. This represents our end value when we solve the equation. In our equation, we need to multiply the x and y values. Let's go ahead and calculate those. We'll also need values for x squared and y squared. Our final step is to find the sum of all of the columns. Now we're ready to start entering our values into the equation. First, let's copy down our formula. Here's the chart with our values. Now let's pick the equation apart. N is the number of x's and y's that we have. In this case, it's 5. We've already calculated the sum of our x values multiplied by the sum of our y values. This is the sum of the x values, and this is the sum of the y values. Again, our n is 5. This is the sum of our x squared values. This is the sum of the x values squared. N is equal to 5. This is the sum of our y squared values. Finally, we need the sum of the y values squared. Let's fill in the formula with these values. Now let's do some simplification. And then divide. The R value turns out to be 0.994. Now that we have the R value, what does that tell us? We know a few things about the R value. It's less than 1 and it's positive. If we were to graph our original x and y data points, the graph would look something like this. We have mathematically determined that the original x and y data has a strong positive correlation. If we return to our idea of old and new lot numbers, we would say that they correlate, and therefore the new control is acceptable. We hope that you found this tutorial helpful. For all of your QC needs, visit www.qcnet.com.